The Caesar Cipher, or Caesar Shift, is one of the earliest known encryption algorithms and was created by none other than Julius Caesar himself to pass secret messages to his officers. It wasn't until about 200 years later that the cipher was actually broken. But, with a little modification, we can make the cipher completely secure once again. So how is it broken in the first place? Well, first we have to look at how the cipher actually works. If you don't know already, it's actually pretty simple. You take any sentence called plain text, we'll use hello world as our example, and shift each letter by X amount of places. Let's say our shift, or key, for this example is 4. H becomes L, E becomes I, L becomes P, and so on until our message is completely encrypted, also known as ciphertext. We then pass the ciphertext along to the recipient, who also has our key of 4, and they shift each letter back that many places to get the plain text. Anyone in between that tries to read it just gets garbled, unusable junk. Sounds simple enough, and the cipher actually worked before a linguist and mathematician finally discovered a way to crack it near 200 years later. The question is, how? Every language has a pattern, a sort of fingerprint, which tells us how often words or even letters are used in the general language itself. For English, the most often used letter is E, followed by T, and close behind that is A. The most commonly used words in order are the, be, to, of, and A. Combining these two facts leads us to draw conclusions on what the ciphertext may actually contain, and thus gets us a huge step closer to decrypting it. The conclusions might be wrong, but then we simply start again with different words. The longer the ciphertext, the more words we have, the better chance we have at getting the right answer. We can also simply use brute force if we need to, which comes in handy with shorter messages. This just means we try each combination one by one and see what comes up. With 24 letters in the English alphabet, there's 24 different combinations to try. It doesn't take too long, but I prefer the first method if it's available. Alright, so let's add some practicality and throw up an example. I'll encrypt a phrase with a random shift and we'll see if we can crack it. We'll enlist the help of a letter frequency chart and a common word chart as well. We'll start with the most common word in the English language, the. Helpfully, this word also contains the most common letter in the English language, E. We'll look at every three-letter word in the ciphertext and try to pair that with our test word. This will be our starting point. The first instance of a three-letter word is CQN, and the second and third three-letter words are ANM. It's also interesting to note that there's two of the same exact three-letter words. From here on in, we can think of this as a simple game of logic. We'll start with CQN and replace it with the, and then find any other matching letters in the phrase. Now, as you can see, we've gotten pretty far just by guessing a single word, so we'll start filling everything in from here. Alright, so we've proven that the Caesar shift is breakable. Now, what if I told you that we could make it unbreakable just by adding some small modifications to it? We'll give that a shot in the next episode. Please do remember to like, comment, and subscribe. If I see more of that, I will of course do more of this, and, as always, I'll see you next time.